Welcome back. It's the Blazor Puzzle. I'm glad you're here. I'm here. I'm Carl Franklin from AppVNext and Jeff Fritz from Microsoft. How you doing, Jeff?
Hey there. I'm not in the friendly confines.
Yeah, where are you?
I'm actually in Stockholm this week. I'm taking part in an event called Svitug. In Stockholm, great developer event that I'm thrilled to be a part of and talk a little bit of Blazor about.
Yimmy and Jessica are the people, Engstrom, are behind it, and I've talked there several times. I love Stockholm. I'm actually going there in May for another conference, the DevSum conference.
Oh, very cool.
Yep. It's conference season coming up here very soon.
It is.
Anyway, let's get to last week's puzzle. So last week, we didn't really have a repo. In fact, we definitely didn't have a repo.
No.
What we had was a challenge. You basically said, you know, there's ways to use JavaScript to minify and bundle, but we want to do it without JavaScript. How do we do that? Well, how do you do it?
So this is something that I feel like we as developers, you need to know in order to make your software real and put it places where people are actually going to use it and to help them have a better experience.
Mm-hmm.
So I want to show you this NuGet package right here. This is the web optimizer from Liger Shark.
Yeah. Mads Christensen.
It's Mads Christensen. Take a look at that download total up there. 3.2 million downloads. Mm-hmm. This has been around for a while, and a lot of folks are using it. And what it does is it gives you the ability to bundle CSS files, bundle JavaScript files, and minify them so that it can be downloaded easier in your .NET projects. Not just Blazor, but ASP.NET Core also. They've got a great GitHub repository out here that you can check out with instructions that shows you exactly how to use it. I put it into a website that I've been working on. Let me show you over in Visual Studio. Here's my program CS where I wanted to bundle up a couple of CSS files. And you can see here on lines 19 through 21, I've got six different CSS files that came as part of a template that I purchased off of a website. And I want to put them all together as one CSS file. So I just say, add CSS bundle, strip out all of the comments, and it gives me one file that I can use called bundle CSS.
Fantastic.
Yeah. I'm also minifying some JavaScript files here, a little bit of jQuery customized extensions that I've put together here. And when I go over to my app Razor, I just swap them in just the same way as if I had another file that I was using. So I've got a bunch of JavaScript files I'm referencing from various CDNs, but right here, I'm including my jQuery customization. And if I scroll up a bit, you can see here's all those CSS files that I was using. I'm going to bundle them all together. And on line 38, I'm going to request just bundle CSS. Makes it a heck of a lot easier.
Yeah, so I noticed that you're not linking all those ones. You're linking bundle CSS, but if you go down to the script tag, you're still, you still have a script tag for jQuery custom, but because you added that in the configuration, the tool knows to minify it.
Yes, it does. So it'll minify it and it'll output it with that same name. So that it just appears, it gets cached in memory and loads very, very quickly from the server.
Okay, great. So just because you call it the same name doesn't mean it's pointing to the same thing.
Exactly.
I think that's what that means. All right. Yep. Wow, very good. This is pretty brilliant. And, you know, Mads, of course, is a brilliant guy.
Oh, yeah.
So, Jeff, let me tell you who won this week. It is, drum roll, please. Armando Salas from Wickenburg, Arizona.
Congratulations, Armando.
Yeah. And just for having his right answer picked from all of the right answers that we got, Armando will be getting one of these. A Blazor Puzzle mug. And also, because we're feeling generous, Armando's going to get one of these.
Yeah.
Blazor Puzzle t-shirt.
Very cool.
And, you know, if you want one of these, you have to play the game. So watch this next puzzle coming up and follow the instructions as to how to send in your entry. Let's get to the next puzzle. All right, so what I have here is a standard Blazor web app in .NET 8. This is using server mode, so it's one project, and I'm also setting it to global, which if you've been paying attention means that AppRaiser has the render mode on the head outlet and on the routes.
Okay.
So here's the deal. I like starting with a template because it gives me all this nice, you know, stuff to mess around with. And I really like these icons, but I noticed that these are BI icons. Those are not the icons that I was used to before.
Yeah.
These are Bootstrap icons. And Bootstrap icons are different from the OI icons that we were using in .NET 7. So let's say I wanted to change this, right? What would I normally do? Well, IntelliSense tells me what's available. This is what I did in .NET 7, right? So I go BI dash, and look at that.
Yeah.
I see only the three that are here are the only ones that are available. And I know that Bootstrap has a lot of different icons. How come they don't ship as part of the template, and how do I get them? That is the question.
Okay.
So, simple question. I want customized, well, not customized, but I want to see the whole Bootstrap icon library. How do I get that, and how do I make it, you know, how do I access it from the nav menu or anywhere else in my app for that matter?
Let's say you wanted to add a form page to demo, right? Just to show, here's how to collect some data as a third page, and you want to put an icon on it.
Right. Or, you know, these icons are cool enough to use everywhere in your app. But I've only got these three in the template. So if you think you know the answer to this, don't post on social media, but instead send it to Jeff and me at blazorpuzzle@appvnext.com. And with the subject, puzzle number 22, and you will be in the running to win.
So if you want to take a picture, you want to take a selfie and show off that you got a solution, you've got extra icons there on the screen with it, that'd be fantastic. Share that on social media, hashtag BlazorPuzzle. We will retweet, we will like and favorite those posts and share them with the community.
Absolutely. And that's it for this week, Jeff. Have a good time in Sweden.
Thanks so much.
And we'll see you next week. Bye-bye.
Take care, friends.
Thanks for watching. Make sure to check out blazortrain.com and the .NET show.com for more great content.